From special films that adapt to changes in heat.
And the really great thing about this is it could become, you know, a shading system that's really easy to retrofit onto existing buildings.
To creating islands in ever-rising seas.
And then over time, we get sand that starts to accumulate in certain areas to rebuild a beach or to build a new island.
Welcome to the range of ideas powering the Self-Assembly Lab at MIT.
The Self-Assembly Lab is really interested in how do we build smarter things and how do we build in a smarter way. And so one of the first things we looked at was the phenomenon of self-assembly.
Skylar Tibbetts heads up the lab, part of the School of Architecture.
Like, how do humans build themselves? How do planets form? You know, these aren't processes where we're building stuff brick by brick with a human hand or even a robot. These are where materials literally come together on their own.
Tibbetts believes our clothing, our buildings, our furniture, all are ready to get smarter.
How can we embed intelligence into the materials around us? And how can they respond to the environment? How can they transform, become lifelike?
Some of the ideas generated at the Self-Assembly Lab have gotten a real-world test on, of all places, Newbury Street.
We've had this incredible mutually beneficial relationship with MIT and the Self-Assembly Lab, where we spend a lot of time in their lab and they spend a lot of time here with us, where we can kind of create novel, exciting solutions, but to real human commercial problems.
Aman Advani, co-founder of the Ministry of Supply and an MIT grad himself. In addition to highly technical fabrics, which are heat responsive, flexible, and non-wrinkling, the Ministry of Supply has offered bespoke 3D printed jackets. They're even collaborating with MIT on using shape-shifting materials with the help of a giant robot arm.
How do we create garments that can actually be changed post-production? So you can make one garment and then actually adjust it into an infinite number of silhouettes after production.
So you don't have to have all these different sizes, all these different styles. It's like ski boots or shin guards, these products that you can morph to your body.
Sure, robots and space-age fabrics are a comfortable fit at MIT, but one doesn't expect to build doctorates out of mud.
It's true. I think I've always had a passion for mud.
Sandy Kurth is a doctoral student working with what's referred to as programmable mud.
So what that means is that we can take a really low-cost material and a really fast manufacturing system, basically a robot squishing out mud to make buildings out of very, very low climate impact materials.
Mud has shown particular promise in formwork molds for concrete, normally constructed out of wood. The mud can often be sourced on site, costs nothing, and is easily recycled. Mud can also be used as a structural element.
We have been building with mud for millennia, although that has really fallen off dramatically in the last 100 years.
Caitlin Mueller, a professor in the architecture department, thinks mud is ready for its day in the sun.
It's also the material that's made to make space shuttles, right? Ceramic tile, it's the same material.
An added bonus that will be music to any builder's ear, 3D printing of programmable mud also makes mistakes easier to cover up.
So we can make a giant 12-foot long beam mold, realize we did something that doesn't quite work, and literally shovel all that material back into our mud pump and just use it again, which is not the case for many engineering prototype systems.
That is so cool. Programmable mud. Who would have thought,
yeah,
right?
It's really taking off as well. It's being used in a lot of different applications. Back to the Ministry of Supply on Newbury Street, those custom fitted dresses, the robot arm that you saw,
yes,
there was on loan from the Self-Assembly Lab. That's now back at the lab, but continues to work on these remarkable shape shifting
yes,
fabrics.
Yes, I
you're in. I know
interested,
you're in.
Interested, indeed.